time. The lessons that I've learned, the lesions that I've earned, were so unkind, so unkind, feeding mind. The forces that decide in your heads reside, you're so divine, so divine. Waste of time.
Yeah.
lessons that I've learned, the lesions that I've earned, were so unkind, so unkind, fading mind. The forces that decide in your head reside, you're so divine, so divine, wasted time.
That what is true for you and your private heart is true for all men, that is genius. Speak your latent conviction and it shall be the universal sense. For always the inmost becomes the outmost, and our first thought is rendered back to us by the trumpets of the last judgment. Familiar as the voice of the mind is to each, the highest merit we ascribe to Moses, Plato, and Milton is that they set at naught books and traditions and spoke not what men, but what they thought. Man should learn to detect and watch that gleam of light which flashes across his mind from within, more than the luster of the firmament of bards and sages. Yet, he dismisses without notice his thought, because it is his. In every work of genius, we recognize our own rejected thoughts. They come back to us with a certain alienated majesty. They teach us to abide by our spontaneous impression with good humor and flexibility. Then most when the whole cry of voices is on the other side. Else tomorrow, the stranger will say, masterly good sense, precisely, we have thought and felt all the time. And we shall be forced to take with shame our own opinion from another. Bravely let him speak the utmost syllable of his confession. We but half express ourselves and are ashamed that divine idea which each of us represents. But God will not have his work made manifest by cowards. Good night.